Good afternoon and thanks Rahul. So I will quickly show some of the practical aspects of what we were discussing since last 1.5 hours. We have gone through the presentation of Rahul and Honorable Chairman Sir, where the different applications were mentioned and how energy storage can support. Of course, Tata Power has done a great work by installing 10 megawatt grid scale energy storage system. We have also installed some of the use case application of energy storage in our area. So we will briefly discuss about that and what were our experience of that and how we are planning to move ahead in this direction. So this is the brief about BSES Yamuna Power Limited, which is operating in east and central part of Delhi, perhaps the most densely populated area of Delhi. One thing here is that we can see that load density in our area is on an average more than 10 megawatt per square kilometer. So that poses a major challenge for us in terms of capacity augmentation and to meet the rising demand of the area. The thing which Honorable Chairman Sir were talking about, that the peak load is around 2% of the time. In our case, it is almost 1% of the time only. And the load curves of typical summer and winter months is shown here. And here we can see that ramping up and ramping down is another challenge for managing the supply position and load position at in our area and Delhi in particular. So during winter months, we experience the difference between minimum and maximum load is almost more than 3 times. So it's a big challenge. And during the summer months, we have 2 peaks. One is around 3 to 4 p.m. in the daytime, and another one is around 11 o'clock in the night, which carries on till midnight. So this is the technology journey for BSES Yamuna Power Limited. And here you can see that we are focusing on this mobility and energy storage space for the last 2 years. We have done a lot of pilot projects in the field of e-mobility and energy storage as well. Apart from that, we are also part of ELAND project, that is basically some use case development of combining all the energy vectors like solar, EV, and of course the energy storage. Then we are doing some project with IIM Ahmedabad for blockchain trading between peer-to-peer and with utility also. So here the energy storage applications for the consumer and behind the meter part is also involved in this experiment or project. Then we have also doing one project of non-intrusive demand response program, and the auto DR project we are also doing at our office building first. We have installed energy storage project coupled with solar rooftop to form a urban microgrid at 4 of our offices. And we are also planning to go for smart EV charging stations owned by us in our area soon. Maybe in next 2 or 3 months, we will be having smart EV charging station where the load will be controlled through SCADA center itself as per the requirement, system requirement. So coming back to the energy storage solutions for a utility, so there are different drivers. So as a utility, we have to identify what is the perfect use case for me, whether behind the meter or in front of the meter at DT level or LV feeder level will work for me, whether the grid scale like Tata Power or the distributed at LT level, distribution transformer level, and then the combining the capacity to get effect of grid scale energy storage is the better solution. Then of course, the professor from Texas was talking about the chemistry, which is also important factor to consider. Indoor versus outdoor, lot of stations and applications are indoor and outdoor, so we have to be cautious while choosing the technology and type of energy storage, whether it can withstand with 46, 47 degree ambient temperature and what will be the efficiency or performance of the battery. Then of course there are certain pockets where you know that there are situations of network congestion there. So whether an energy storage solution can provide relief to that congestion or not. Then we talked about the DSM management also. So the combined capacity or a grid scale capacity can be utilized towards DSM management and some sort of arbitrage also going forward, as we will be having some more liquid market coming from this 1st of April, and there will be a lot of changes in the regulation and the way we see the real-time markets. And another one is that a lot of RE integration is there, not only embedded within my licensee area, but also owing to renewable purchase obligations, I have tied up around 25% of renewable power out of my total power supply portfolio. So there will be intermittency and variability towards supply side. So how to deal with that? Can energy storage solution be the solution for tackling that challenge or problem? So for BYPL, we have selected for some energy storage initiative at different levels, starting with at our office level, which is behind the meter scene. We have installed energy storage solution of maximum 10 kilowatt at 4 locations, coupled with the solar rooftop, and analyzed the data where we found that 60 to 70% of the time our office was self-dependent. It didn't draw any power from the grid. Only 30% of the time it was dependent on the grid. So we have to see that whether the behind the meter energy storage solution could be a viable option, and for that we need the regulatory environment and regulations to support how we should incentivize the consumers and how this thing can be can come into existing regulation, or separate regulation is required to do it. So along with that, we have also released the purchase order of installation of 1 megawatt hour energy storage at 5 of our distribution transformer level of 200 kilowatt each. So there we will be doing different sort of experiment dedicated to different drivers where we don't have a space, where the local network congestion is there, and by combining the all 5 energy storage system, can we get some sort of relief at DSM part, and can it be a part of my day-ahead supply planning also. Of course, for the grid scale level, we are already in the talks with SECI to have some sort of grid scale energy storage system within Delhi. Mr. Rahul and his team is assisting SECI for analysis and report part. So this is brief about the system. I was mentioning the microgrid part, the energy storage coupled with the solar, rooftop solar at one of our offices. Basically, these are 4 sites. So as I have already told that 70% of the time the office was dependent in terms of energy consumption. These are the different key highlights of that particular projects. Then we have also learned that the charging and discharging cycles for energy storage plays a very important role. So you should know when to charge and when to discharge energy storage so that it can be utilized optimally. At the same time, your charging cycles are fixed, so it is not used in a haphazard way, or where the energy battery life is reduced drastically because of unplanned type of charging and discharging cycles. It acted as the placement of DG at our offices and contributed towards some sort of reduction in DSM charges. And at the time of need, you can allow an energy storage to discharge the energy into the grid, and this can act as a demand response program when simultaneous connected capacity is utilized towards that. Of course, there was a reduction of CO2 emission because of the solar rooftop installed at that particular building. So this is our forthcoming project of 1 megawatt hour to be located at 4 of the distribution transformer level at different locations, catering to different needs. One is where we don't have space to expand our network. Cost is another consideration, and it is very important consideration. For installation of around 1 megawatt capacity at distribution level, normally we take around 1 to 1.5 crore of rupees for installation of 1 megawatt capacity. So as long as the battery energy storage system cost doesn't come to that level, provided space is available, the viability of energy storage system has to be looked into. If you have space and other things are in favor of you, that it is very difficult to install this energy storage system because of the cost, but we are very optimistic that in coming times the cost of energy storage will come to $100 level, so that viability can be increased. So this is the proposed schematic of the five of the locations where we intend to install 200 kilowatt hour application, energy storage applications. Along with that, we are also experimenting with smart EV charging system. So soon we will be having a charging station, EV charging station at our one of the grid, so where we will be having the overall output control of that particular EV charger from the SCADA control. So this could also act as a demand response program. We are also thinking of adding some energy storage capacity along with this charging station, so that at the time of need, the same can be fed into the EVs also. So this is again one sort of new application and some innovative idea. So this is all from our side. So thank you, Rahul.